and exponential reasonable functions to it. So SAE means on C, probably you know what it means, or what you say. So there will be three lectures, the title of the lecture. The first one will be various objects that you can study with SAE. Okay, so today we'll talk about the connection between statistical mechanics, scalars, and how you can use all these tricks with SAE. What I'm going to talk is first what are the objects we deal with. Then, second part will be again statistical physics and color. And the third part will be SAE. Definition of how you construct SAE. So, the objects we are going to deal with are curves. And to be simpler, this will be curves in planar domains. So the data will be a domain, D. And to be simple, there will be mark points that you can choose either on the boundary of the domain or in the belt. So far from the boundary, so two mark points. And then you have curves which go from one point to the other one. And what SAE does, it gives you a way to construct measure on curves. And the measure depends on the data, depends on the domain, and on the mark point. And it's a measure on curves with a few properties, which will be characteristic of this measure. Is to try to understand what are this property and how this property are enough to fully construct the measure. So let me start with an example of the object we are dealing with, starting from the left. So the first example is the one which was used by Schramm to define SLE. So SLE was defined by Schramm in a in 1999. And the first example uses loop arrays monomorph. Which is abbreviated as LARW. So what happened? How you can construct loop arrays monomorph? You can take a lattice, it's a square like this. And on the lattice, you may consider random walk on the lattice. So you look at it. Random walk. On lambda, if lambda is a lattice. G2. And so you may consider all the loop, colors, you look at the random walk. And you know that in 2 dimensions, random walk is, it's recurrent in the sense that it goes back, it visits the same point many times, actually an infinite number of times. So you take random walk. So because it visits any visit site many times, it means that there are loops, it forms loops when you look at the graph of the random walk, so you have many loops. So you may look at all the paths which go from one point to another one, so all the random walk which go from two map. So the way to obtain loop memory of random walk is to take one of these random walk and just erase the root. So here there was a loop, I want to erase them. So you have to do it in a chronological order, but doesn't matter much. So I go back here. So that was a loop. And here I have another loop. So I get a curve. On the lattice, so that's a thick curve, which is a simple curve. So this is curve anyway. From random walk by erasing the loop. And this is a simple curve. Meaning that it visits, when you visit a point, it visits only once in that form. Now if you want to, we want to give a measure on that curve, so we have to define probability measure on this set of objects. If you fix the two target points here and here, and fix the domain on the domain as a finite size, there is only a finite number of such objects, so it's very easy to define measure. The way it's done, and how SLE is defined, is that you associate a weight to a new curve. So you take a curve, simple, from x0, let's say, x infinity. So you want to, we give a weight to this curve, so you have set a weight to gamma, which I put the value of gamma. And then, so the way to define this weight is just to look at all the random walk which will produce a curve gamma when you erase the loop. So you consider all, you sum over all the random walk which give gamma when you erase the loop. So here, if I pick a curve, let me pick that one, then if I made a random walk, I have added a loop here, or here, or here, I sum over all the possibilities which of all the curve loops, which when you erase the loops, give gamma. And then I put a weight, which is just fugacity, some number, mu, let's say, to the number of steps. So since you give a weight to any curve, like the finite number of curves, the probability of the curve, g of gamma, will be just the value of gamma, normal. So this is defining measure on curve, on the lattice. It's critical when the random walk are critical, which means that mu has to be 1/4 there, because there is some possibility at each step. And the statement is that when it's critical, you can take the limit, continuum limit. So the continuum limit exists. And the continuum limit corresponds to fix the size of the domain. So you fix D. And you take the limit when the mesh of the lattice goes to zero.
What is Z?
The normalization, so the partition function.
Yeah,
everything is discrete, everything is finite, it's like a finite block here. So, so when you take the continuum limit, nothing is finite, so you have to deal with. But the continuum limit exists, and you give, then you get measure on curves, which are simple. Still in the continuum, on simple curve, in D, from x0 to x infinity. And this curve are one of the examples of SLE, and they are called SLE2, because SLE depends on one parameter.
Excuse me. What makes mu c critical? I mean,
and you want the random walk. And you want you don't want finite climax of the system. So that's why you want mu critical. You want a proper. You know that when you look at the random walk, even at the random walk on the lattice, if you define it by just defining the fugacity. You want it to be linked, for example, to the Laplace. So, no? Okay. For that, for the one who could be assumed to the Markov process generated by the Laplace, mu has to be one proper. Okay. So that's the value of mu.
What is the definition of critical?
There is no correction axis in here. What's the correction over? So the object has mean that. You need to be at the critical point in order to go to the critical point in order to be able to take the scaling limit, otherwise when you take the scaling limit the object will shrink to a point.
So you need to have an object which has infinite extension in order to be able to take the scaling limit.
So when you are at the critical point you can take the continuum limit, you get an object which has a meaning in the continuum, which is two is called simple curve, and this curve has a fractional dimension, a fractal dimension, which is a rational number, which is for 5/4, so it's bigger than 1, which means that it has any curve has an infinite length, if you measure the length as a number of steps, so it's an object which is fractal.
Sorry, can I just ask for clarification?
What?
When you erase these loops,
yeah.
Is that a uniquely defined procedure?
No, you have to do it in the chronological order. Okay. There's a specific way to define it. I don't want to understand it. Okay, so that's one example which is some connection with the simple mode, but not one. So another example I want to look at is the interpolation. So again, I will start with the lattice. So I take a triangular lattice at times. The lambda like a triangular lattice. Which is more difficult to draw. Choosing things that each of the vertex is either is either
say. White or black?
So you have a probability P having white vertex and 1 minus P with black.
Okay. So again, I imagine that my lattice is inside some domain at finite size. So there is a finite number of configuration. And to give a configuration, it's just to give the data that you have black or white lattices.
So you give the data either black or white on each of the vertices. It's defined for you what is the configuration. And each configuration is equipped with a probability, because it's just a probability of choosing either white or black in each of the sides. Now, so that will be clusters of white and black vertices. And the object we want to understand is the boundary of these clusters, which are curves. So in order to have a control on that curve, you choose specific boundary conditions. So I look at a domain where this is my boundary, for instance. So this is the boundary of the domain.
Let's say it's close to,
let's say this is a real axis. And I choose that the other points which are x0 is not. All the points which are on the left of x0 will be white. And all the points which are on the right are black. Okay? Now, so that's a fixed boundary. I impose this boundary condition. Now, if I look at the realization, I will choose randomly the color of these vertices. But I am sure that for any sample, there will be an interface which starts here and goes somewhere. Why? So, for example, when I'm here, I have chosen one color of the vertices, let's say white. So this means that my interface will go here. If this one is black, for instance, I know that the interface will go here. Okay? So there will be always be an interface starting at this mark point because of the boundary condition I choose. And how I can construct the interface is just by moving along this step by step, moving along the interface. So if I have done a certain number of steps, here I have done 3 steps, then I hit one of the vertices, and I have to choose the color of these vertices randomly. So with probability P, I choose it to be either white, and with probability 1 minus P, I choose it to be black. So for example, if I choose it to be black, then I know that my interface will move to the left. Now for the next step, again, I hit one of the vertices, and to move either to the left or to the right, I have to choose the color of that vertex. With probability P, it's white, 1 minus P is black, so let's say actually black. So what you see from that is that you can construct the curve by an exploration procedure, okay? That's what SLE will do. So by an exploration, so you explore the domain, and here, in the case of percolation, you choose a vertex locally close to the tip of the curve to know where it goes, and you will know the probability to move to the left or to the right. So again, that's been proved by Smirnov. So that was proved by Schramm. has been proved by
Zvianov. That preparation that you can take the continuum limit, the continuum limit exists. And you get a curve, which is one of the examples of SLE, so you get Majorian curve in your domain. And this corresponds to another value of the parameter of unit vector scalar, so it's called SLE 6. But what you get here, you don't get a simple curve. This curve will have many, many, many double points. So it means that in the continuum limit, the curve will move and touch itself many times. So it's a curve with many double points, but always the tip of the curve is away outside the domain which has been swallowed by the curve during the process. That's the outside, because you have to be able to decide when you move, or you have to be able to decide which vertex you choose, the color of the vertex you choose. So here, if it was white here, I see that this cluster is white actually. When I move, so this one is black, this one is black, then it's white, and so on. So then the curve is over many, many of the clusters. Many clusters which touch themselves. And there is many double points. So the continuum limit will be an infinite number of double points. But the curve never crosses itself. So you get a curve with finite dimension, which is seven on the four. And the finite dimension of the set of the double point is less than one because they are discrete; they don't form a continuum. So that's another example. So these two examples are geometric example. But what we learn from that is that in the continuum limit we get either simple curve or curve with non-simple curve with many double points. And we also learn that we will construct a measure by an exploration process. Okay. That's enough for the example. Now I will move to statistical mechanics of measure on curves. To any of this configuration, I associate a weight. which is just exponential minus beta, so energy of the configuration. And as you know, energy of the configuration will be sum over G sigma I sigma G. I, G, 2 neighborhood on the lattice. And the probability of each configuration is simply given by the ratio between this weight and the partition function, which normalizes the probability to 1. So now I want to give this curve. So as I did for percolation, I will impose boundary condition in order to control the position of the curve is the starting point. And to be sure that for any realization, I will have a curve which I will be able to deal with. So the curve we want to study as the interface between the clusters of spin plus or minus. So then when you look at the configuration, you may have plus, plus, plus somewhere. So you have plus, clusters of plus with inside clusters of minus, minuses. And this means that at the boundary of this cluster, on one side you have minuses, on the other side you have pluses. So that's the curve we want to look at. So in order to control the existence of such a curve, we choose 2 points, which I call x naught and x infinity on the boundary. And I choose plus on this side, on this arc of the domain, and minuses on the other side. Okay. Then for any realization, if my lattice was here, I will always know that there will be an interface with plus on the left and minuses on the right. Okay? And this interface is written on the dual lattice. Of course, there is a cluster of pluses, minuses, pluses. There is a full collection of clusters away from the curve, but there is at least this curve, which starts from which link, which is go from x0 to x infinity or x infinity to x0. Okay. So, what is the probability of the curve? So that's the probability of occurrence of this curve is simply given by Boltzmann rules for statistical mechanics. That's what I'm going to do to be this measure. So the probability, but I'm going to explain that the Boltzmann rules is like measure. So but the probability of having gamma, this is simply 1/partition function. So the probability of improvement for configuration C W C over the partition function Z. Okay, is Z sum over the configuration of the W C. Now the probability of the curve gamma is rule of the so there is many configurations which correspond to a given curve. So I fix a curve here, gamma. The only information I have on the configuration is there is plus on this side and minus on this side. And all the other spin can be whatever they want. So there is many configurations corresponding to one given curve. Okay? So to compute this probability, I just have to sum the probability of having all these configurations given this curve, okay? So that will be the sum, that will be 1/z 1 over C, which implies gamma over W. Probability measure you get from statistical mechanics. So we just say a bit differently these things. I consider C the configuration space. Okay? So that's a set of all configuration. So here, when I sum over all configurations in C. Now, when I pick a curve, I select a subset of configuration.
Sorry.
Yeah.
So, we're trying to build a measure on the curves, but using the configuration of the Easy model, are we sure that the measure on the curves is normalized?
That's what I'm going to do.
Oh, okay, sorry.
So, given gamma, I define a C of gamma, which is a subset of C, okay, which is a set of configuration which produce a curve. Which means that in that configuration, only thing I have imposed is that it's pluses everywhere here, minuses everywhere here. Of course, this C of gamma forms a partition of C. So C is the union of C of gamma. I cover all configuration when I just change the curve. Because when I given configuration, I change curve. And this is, they are all, if I change it, this is a partition because the intersection, these are all distinct sets. If I have both curve, there is no two curves which belong,
two configurations which belong to the set.
To two different sets, C of gamma. So they form a partition. Now, what I have defined? Okay. So I can define, given this data, I have, what I, when I do this sum here, is a sum over C of gamma. Okay? So now my construction, when you sum over all gamma, it means that you sum over all C of gamma, because you form a partition, you complete the sum, and then normalize to one. Okay? So that's a normalized probability. And what you see from here is that, actually, as always in statistical mechanics, probability is the ratio of two partial functions. That's this partial function, and that's a conditional partial function. So what I can write is that P of gamma is the ratio of Z, some partition function depending on gamma or Z, with Z again the sum over all the configuration of C, of WC, and Z of gamma is just the sum over my subset of configuration which produces gamma. And all these objects depend on the data I have. So that depends on D and the two mark point, x infinity. This also depends on D, x0 and x infinity. This one depends on E because of the set. So that's so what you learn, that statistical mechanics can use by construction measure of curves. Now the problem that you have thanks to is to take the scaling limit, continuum limit. And none of these objects exist in the continuum limit. But what SLE shows that you can give a meaning to the limit of the ratio of the two partial functions.
But this will not be done by taking the limit. It will be done by looking at what are the constraints, what properties this measure satisfies, and imposing this property in the continuum.
I'm sorry.
Okay. Does it answer your question?
The total normalization cannot depend on its zero at its infinite.
It does, because all the set configured this set depend on the. You are in the domain.
Yes.
You are in the domain. So.
Yes.
Going over to the domain, you have imposed plus here, plus here.
Minus here.
So they depend. Okay, so now we have understood that we got the measure. Now we want to see what's the property of the measure. So that's the main observation by Schwann, which is it's called 2C, the condition. The domain Markov property. So what I want to do is condition on some portion of the curve. So I start with my data. Again, V. I'm going to write this drawing on the pipe, so something like that. So I have the data, x0, x infinity. So I am supposed to look at curves which go from x0 to x infinity. But I want to condition on a portion of the curve. So I give myself some portion of the curve from x0 to x inside. Okay? So what I'm asking is what happens when I do condition. So I do a conditioning on a portion of the curve. From gamma x0 to x. Starting at x0 up to x. So I will write it in the form of, let's say, the concatenation of two curves, gamma of x0, x, and x, x infinity. But since I condition here, this is fixed, so this is a random element, okay? Okay? Condition probability. But what we are going to prove on this follows from statistical mechanics, but it is the same thing, so that it can be read, it is equal to another object, another measure on curve. Because if you look at this measure, what is the support of this measure? I told you that the random element here is just a curve from x to x infinity. So this condition probability is actually a measure whose support is curve starting at x going to x infinity. Okay? So that will be equal. The probability of the curve x, x infinity, but it has to start at x, it goes to x infinity, and what is the domain? The domain is, because it starts at x, the domain has to be symmetrically connected, so it will be d, but when cut along the portion of the curve. So it will be in D minus gamma x 0 0 s. Okay? So we are going to prove that. So that's called double Markov property. And this follows from stat statistics. So it's true in general. Oof. So why this is not completely absurd? That we started with boundary condition as energizing model, we have plus everywhere here, and minus everywhere here. If we condition on the curve, it means that we have selected configuration where there is plus, minus, here. So we reproduce a good boundary condition for this measure here. We have in D minus gamma, we view from X, we have plus on the left and minus on the right. Okay. So now it's very easy to prove it. So what is the condition probability? It's a ratio of two probabilities. Okay? So probability, so check. Probability of Rudy gamma x0 x infinity condition gamma x0 x. That's the ratio of two probabilities. PD of having the full curve x0 x x infinity divided by the probability in D with the maximum x0 and x infinity of the curve of the portion on which we condition. Okay, well, again, this is here the random bias. That's the definition of a condition probability. Probability of, probably you know it, but probability of A condition on B, probability of A inter B, what probability of so A inter B is this curve. Okay? Now, I told you that probability is a ratio of partition function. So that's this probability, Z, what I call Zd of gamma x0 x, gamma x infinity over Zd. That is probability. Well, then I have to divide by this probability, which is Zd of gamma x0 x over Zd. Okay? So I can simplify. So I simplify. And I have the ratio of this partition function, which are not yet completely linked to the partition function in T minus. But if I can erase. But what is for some, let me look for some at this object here. Zd over gamma x0 x. This is a sum over all configuration which belong to my subset selected by the portion of the curve. So what does it mean, this set? Is that you have D x infinity, x, 0, and I have a portion of curve here, x, and I have plus, minus. Here, because I select the curve, so I know that there is plus here. So that's D. So this set actually is the same thing as the set of in D minus gamma of x0 x is all the configuration in the complement of D minus x0. Yes?
Yeah, I was just wondering, isn't there a factor of 1/2 somewhere, because it's the second curve has the plus on the same side as the first curve? Why is not? Because you have the first curve, from x0 to x, then you have the pluses on one side and the minus on the other side.
Yeah.
And so the probability that the other curve has the plus on the same side. You don't have to think about that.
So when you say the first curve is the distortion of the curve. Yeah? So now, that's a probability measure on the curve, okay? So if I want to compute the probability here, so that's a function which was argumented that one. So I choose a curve, which I call gamma from x to x infinity, blindly. When I choose this curve, to compute that, I have to look at all the configurations with x plus. Minus.
Okay.
Huh? And then I compute with this.
Yeah. Okay. Boundary conditions stay the same.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
So this set here, in which I sum to define the restriction partial function, is exactly the same as the set of configuration in the domain cut along the portion of the curve by construction. Okay. Now. Is this weight exactly the same as the weight in? So this weight is minus beta p, and I will tell you that this is just sum over all the neighborhood. This is my region, maybe name. So it looks as if they are exactly the same. The only difference is that here, actually, this definition depends on d. And when you are in D, you include all the links which are here in the sum. Okay? Whereas you are in D minus gamma, you don't. Okay. So only difference between here is that in D, this is the same thing as some energy for the curve, gamma in D, times configuration in D minus gamma. Okay? So this means that this partial function is actually up to a prefactor which depends on the curve gamma, the same as d minus gamma of x naught. Okay? Partial function has another function, contrary to what you learn, they are section of a bundle because they are defined up to a multiplicative constant. So here, when you condition, you get by the partial function up to a constant. But you will get the same constant here because it just links to all the links that you have break, all the edges that you have break with gamma. So they compensate. So this one is because the prefactor compensate, which links to the energy of the interface. This one compensate, and so you get Zd minus gamma from x. X0 of the rest of the curve divided by Gd minus x0, which is effectively that. So, it means that the statistical mechanics, if you have a local interaction, you get this double map of complex. Okay?
Excuse me, what is Ec of d minus gamma?
That's all the net. When you have this term, you sum over all edges. So when you are in D, you sum over all edges which have been crossed by the curve. Okay? So this defines that's this sum here. So it's since you have plus here, minus here, is J times the number of edges you have crossed. Okay? This is what I call E of gamma. Okay? Not just the energy, let's get to the But if you factorize for any configuration, you can factorize it. And the same will be true if you look at the partial function where you are restricted over the curve, you will still have these prefactors when you are in D compared to when you are in D minus gamma. So we have at least one property of the measure that we want to preserve when we go to the continuum limit. And that's the one we will use. So now I will construct essay. We forget about the continuity of the lattice things. Just remember about this quadratic. And we directly in the continuum, or construct the measure in the continuum. That's all that I wanted to say. Now. So the way it is done is done. Yeah. So as I said, it's defined a measure. So let's define measure on curve. Gamma. On D. From two mark from x to x infinity. And there will be two properties. There will be one property which is conformal transport. So that's the extra property that you will have compared to what we have done up to now, that you expect from statistical physics, and the main Markov property. So the demanding these two properties fix determine completely the measure. So that's what we are going to. If you are demanding only one of the two, you will not be able to specify the measure. Okay, we have seen that the main Markov property is valid on the lattice, just from by the rule of statistical mechanics, so it's valid away from criticality too. Okay. So the construction is done directly in the continuum. Does it mean that for a while we will forget about statistical mechanics, just talk about algebra? Okay. So in particular, we will lose completely the relation between measure we are trying to study and model of statistical mechanics. So at some point we will have to establish to go back to the statistical model, this is what we are interested in. So we have to make a connection between SLE, this measure, on the continuum, and the regular statistical model. And that's one of the purposes of the connection between SLE and CFT, is to establish the connection between the measure construed by Schramm in the continuum and the lattice model we started with. Okay. So, I will explain how to deal with these two properties in the continuum. And the first thing I have to tell you is what is conformal transport. And to tell you what is conformal transport, I will just remind you a few basic facts about conformal transformations. And then we will go. So I'm pretty sure that you know that conformal transformations are transformations which present angles. So they are locally, they are dilatation and rotation. So in two dimensions, these are transformations preserving. Angles. This means that if you start with a sum lattice and move into another lattice, still with
So if z is a complex coordinate in a transformation, if z is holomorph, so to z you have a function of z. And clearly this preserves the angle, because if you look at a small transformation, delta w, so locally, some point z0, you have a transformation delta w. If you start from delta z, we go to delta w is equal to f prime of z0 times delta z. So locally, the tiny vector is either dilated by the module of f prime or rotated at an angle given by the argument. So that's locally. Locally. Rotation. Then there is an important theorem, which is called the Riemann-Mantel theorem. Which says that if you take that any two simply connected simply connected domains on the plane are conformally equivalent. So I take the domain here. This is another domain is a planar domain. Both of them are connected and simply connected. That's why it's u is the delta. Then there is a conformal map from one to the other. F. So basic example is from you go from the unit circle u to 0 from 1. So you take the unit disk, center at 0. And this is conformally equivalent to the upper half plane, h, where this is 0 and this is I. So the map will be f of z. So I want to, the boundary of the unit circle will go to here, the real axis. 0 will go to I, for instance. So it should be something like z plus 1 over z. Forget. Something like that. To infinity, 0 to I, and minus 1 to 0. So it's a one-to-one map between the two. And given two domains, there is always a map between the two domains. But this map is not unique. There is a three social map is defined up to three parameters. And the way to see it is that any domain can be mapped by this theorem to the upper half plane. Okay. So now, to see the invariance in the choice of f, we only have to see what are the conformal map which map the upper half plane into itself. Okay. So we look for map. On edge. To h. Again, this is a problem. on this set of maps from a group, which is SL2 class, which have a set of transformations F, F, such as Z, is sent to A, Z, B, C, Z, D, A, B, C, D is equal to a real number. And since they are defined to dilatation, we may put the determinant. And there is still a Z factor you can factor out. So, to fix the map, you need three parameters. You put three conditions in order to fix maps. It means that a uniformizing map set from D to H is defined up to three real parameters. Okay. So that's all what we know. We need to about conformal transformation. They are just there is a theorem which tells you that any domain, if there is no hole in it, if it's, and if it's simply collected, so if a leak is can be conformally mapped to the upper plane or to the unit disk. So it can be mapped to a reference domain that we can choose that way. But this mapping is to specify this mapping, so to which will be a way to characterize the domain, you have to specify three conditions. That's all what we need. Okay, so this theorem will not be true if there is a hole in it. That will, for an annulus cannot be mapped into the disk. They don't have the same topology. So that's the input that we will use to construct a set.
Nice.
I think we do it back.
Yes. Have a question?
Yes.